Hi everyone, welcome back to Bottom Science. Today we are going to understand the concept of normalization in quantum mechanics. Before starting this tutorial, make sure you understand the concept of wave function, which I've already covered in my previous tutorials. So I will put that link in the description and make sure you just watch it before covering this video. And in this video, we'll try to cover what is normalization, why it is necessary to normalize a wave function before using it for further calculation, and what normalization condition is, which is nothing but mathematical description of it. Everything will be covered in this small video, so make sure you watch it till the end. So let's start it. First of all, what is normalization? Not only in quantum mechanics, normalization procedure is used in so many fields. So in general, it is mathematical procedure used to scale values to a common range or standardize them in a particular way. Now, why it is necessary to normalize a wave function? So before using the wave function in any calculation, we generally normalize it first. And why we do it? It is because it ensures that the total probability of finding the particle in all possible state is equal to 1. In other words, we can say that by normalizing the wave function, we ensure that the probabilities associated with the different states of a system are properly defined and consistent. Now comes to the question, what normalization condition is? Mathematically, normalization condition is expressed as integral of a square magnitude of wave function over all possible states, which must be equal to 1, where psi is the wave function and psi square represents the probability density, and integral is taken over all possible values of the variable x, which could represent position, momentum, etc. So I hope you have understood the concept of normalization from this tutorial. If you have any question, you can put it as a comment and we will try to answer it. And in the coming tutorial, I will try to cover how to normalize a wave function in a detailed manner, and we'll try to cover it through an example. And here's the playlist of our previous tutorial, so make sure you follow it. So thanks for watching it. See you soon.